light, the curtain's drawn, the table's set. I wanna be, I wanna be at my best. It's bittersweet, it's poetry.
Please don't scar this. For those of us blessed by a true partnership of love, we feel safe in the presence of our loved one. There is no need to hide any part of ourselves for fear of being judged or rejected. We can just be together from moment to moment, believing that those moments will thread together into eternity. There is a gentleness to the presence of love that softens life's rough edges. It makes us somehow braver to go forth into the world, knowing that the shelter of someone's love awaits us at the end of the day. We are most vulnerable when we are in love. We place our trust in another to honor us and care for us, to treasure us and to receive our love. In love, we trust that the other will provide a safe haven in which we can experience and share the fullness of our being with one another. And in doing so, we trust that our lives will be far richer than had we chosen separate journeys through this world. We trust that our love will fill us and make us wiser and more compassionate beings. We find that our union graces our lives with balance and sweetness beyond any we have ever tasted, and a treasure beyond any measure of value we have ever known. And from Ephesians, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
Say here. It took many failed attempts and lots of doodles to finally realize that this isn't difficult. Difficult is trying to find that one person that makes every day better and loves you no matter what. So relax, the hard part's done. I love waking up and finding you've left me a little note with my breakfast. It's a small gesture, but it makes me smile, which at 4 a.m. there isn't much to smile about. So Molly, I vow to love you always, especially when it's not easy. Which leads me to my next vow, to never finish a TV series without you. To be strong when you are weak, and patient when I am weak. To occasionally compliment your eyebrows, even without being prompted. They look great, by the way. Might as well get a head start on that one. To be the voice of reason when it comes to adding pets. And when necessary, send meat roosters to meet Jesus. To be there for you, whether that means simply sitting there quietly while you vent, or keeping those toes in check, or just making you laugh. I'll be there. Molly, I love you.
Wonderful.
Not yet. Nick, you're a set of beautiful contradictions. You have a soft, honest heart and a strong mind. You are straightforward, yet you love an indecisive woman like me. Getting to know you and love you these near 5 years has been the pleasure of my life. You changed everything for me, gently pulling my life in a new direction. I've said from the very beginning that I trust you implicitly. It's not just your million-watt smile or your Leonardo DiCaprio good looks. It's the way you hug me after we've had a hard day, the way you see all of my strengths, even when I don't, and accept my shortcomings always. You are my partner, lover, teacher, and confidant. And I've never laughed so hard, smiled so much, or felt the confidence I do when we are together.
Ooh. It's okay.
We chose each other, and I want to keep choosing and always fighting for you and what we have together. I promise to pursue your heart and what makes you happy. I promise to always feign interest in the YouTube videos you show me. I promise I will change and I will grow, but our happiness will remain my priority. I promise to encourage you in all of your ventures and support you through triumph and tragedy. I promise to always laugh the loudest at your jokes. As your wife, I promise to show you what it is to take care of you and what we have together as a family. Lastly, I will do my very best to make you white bean chicken chili as often as I can stand to. And I love you the very most.
Okay. Under the authority of the laws of the state of Ohio, now pronounce you married, husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
I will. would please rise as we introduce for the second time tonight, Mr. and Mrs. Nick and Molly Allen.
For those of you that know me, you know I can't do funny like Nick does. But I've been married longer than you, so I can pass on some unsolicited advice. As you move forward in your marriage, find a church, root yourselves in it. Moving forward, forget who you were. As you grow in your marriage, grow together. As one person, as one flesh.
So naturally, I found a quote that I hope will embody the union between Nick and Molly throughout their lives together. Here it goes. Find someone who makes you realize three things. One, that home is not a place, but a feeling. Two, that time is not measured by a clock, but by moments. And three, that heartbeats are not heard, but felt and shared. I think you two have found that in each other, and I hope you think back on these words when times get tough. Because we all know you two bring out the best in each other, and it radiates so much love into the world and makes all of our hearts happy. So now that we've reached my sappy quota for the night, let's all raise our glasses. I wish you both the best on this new adventure. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Adams. I love you. Cheers!
They mean more than gold. May you win, but stay humble. and know when you stumble, you're never alone. Never alone.
Motivation, that's the consistency, the key is the perseverance, the eyes will take me in a career, those are optimistic, opening never shut. And the aim is necessary, cause I'm never giving up. Didn't ask me how I did it from the heart. Crushing the competition, been doing it from the start.